When some loud bragger tries to put me down and says his school is great, I tell him right away, now what's the matter, buddy? Ain't you heard of my school? It's number one in the state.
Hey, hey, take it away! Get that ball and fight!
So be to your school!
Your job's a joke, you broke, your love life's DOA. It's like you're always stuck in second gear, when it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year. But I'll be there for you.
Class of 1973, to the 50th anniversary of your graduation from Edgewood High School of the Sacred Heart. I've been at Edgewood, well, counting my years as a student, 60 years. So I've seen a lot of classes go through Edgewood, and I want you to know that you've been one of my favorites. I have lots of memories from your class, some of them even fond. I hope you'll take advantage of this time together to reacquaint yourselves with each other and perhaps talk to people you didn't talk to when you were in high school. You'll have a great time and hopefully see you again in 5 years. So welcome back to your high school alma mater.
Life, so they say, is but a game and they let it slip away. Love, like the autumn sun, should be dying, but it's only just begun. Like the twilight in the road up ahead, they don't see just where we're going. All the secrets in the universe whisper in our ears. All the years come and go, take us up, always up. We may never pass this way again. We may never pass this way. Say, for the fools and they let them drift away. Peace, like the silent dove, should be flying, but it's only just begun. Like Columbus in the olden days, we must gather all our courage. Sail our ships out on the open sea. Cast away our fears, and all the years will come and go. Take us up, always up. We may never pass this way again. We may never pass this way again. We may never pass this way again.
So I won't laugh while the laughing is easy. I wanna cry if it makes it worthwhile. I may never pass this way again. That's why I want it with you. Cause you make me feel like I'm more than a friend. Like I'm the journey. The journey's end.
My time was running wild, a million dead-end streets, and every time I thought I got it made, it seemed the taste was not so sweet. So I turned myself to face me. I've never caught a glimpse of how the others must see the faker. I'm much too fast to take that test.
Change it.
Turn and face the strain.
Change it.
don't wanna be a richer man.
Changes.
It's gonna have to be a different man. Thou may change me, but I can't trace time. Ooh, yeah. I watch the ripples change the size, but never leave the stream. Permanent sand, so the days float through my eyes, but still the days seem the same. And these children that you spit on as they try to change their worlds are immune to your consultations. They're quite aware of what they're going through.
Changes. Strange
changes. Don't tell them to grow up and out of it.
Changes. Turn and face the strange
changes. Where's the shame you've left us up to her next to me? Time may change me, but you can't twist time. Strange fascination, fascinating. Changes are taking the pace I'm going through.
Changes.
Turn and face the strange
changes.
Oh, look out, you rock and rollers.
Changes. Turn and face the strange
changes. Pretty soon now you're gonna get older. Time may change me, but I can't trace time. That time may change me, but I can't trace time.
Hey buddies that I grew up with, all straight-laced and married up now. You ain't fooling me, wasn't long ago we tore the roof off that one red light town. And hey darling, sipping that red wine, all classic kick back on the couch. You smile and I see you shooting tequila, us shutting them college bars down. And no matter how much time goes by, and no matter how much we grow up, for worse or for better, from now till forever, I'll always remember you young. Hey babies, crawling on the carpet, no you won't be that little for long. One day you'll move away, but you're still gonna stay this innocent after you're gone. Cause no matter how much time goes by, and no matter how much you grow up, for worse or for better, from now till forever, I'll always remember you. Looks at us all like we're kids, shameless and painless and perfect and ageless. Forgives all the wrong that we did. And no matter how much time goes by, I hope we never have to grow up. And you'll say for worse or for better, from now till forever.
I'm 15 for a moment, caught in between 10 and 20, and I'm just dreaming, counting the ways to where you are. I'm once wanted to for a moment. And she feels better than ever. We're on fire, making our way back from Mars. 15, there's still time for you. Time to buy and time to lose. 15, there's never a wish better than this. When you only got 100 years to live. Still the man, but you see I'm a they, a kid on the way, babe, a family on my mind. I'm 45 for a moment. The sea is high and I'm heading into a crisis, chasing the years of my life.
Introduce us. They were out for a stroller walk. We actually lived a few blocks apart. When we were about 3 years old, we found out that we were born 24 hours apart.
Yep, and then 2 years later, my parents moved to the Hoyt Park area, and that was the end of that for a while until we graduated from eighth grade, and that summer we were on the playground of Blessed Sacrament, and Fred Sweeney and Greg Townsend pointed out the Google girl. How neat she looked, and I thought, wow, she is something special. Way past my pay grade.
Then freshman year, the nuns at Edgewood actually had a little hand in it. They gave us the exact same schedules in freshman year, except for math. He was way too smart for me. So I got to know him, got to know each other pretty well then.
Yep. And you asked me out to twerp.
A sophomore year, I asked him out to tour.
Didn't go real well because I had a lot of growing up to do yet. And I take full blame for that.
And then junior year, we started out actually the basketball tournaments in Milwaukee. We started out going out again and been together ever since.
Yep. I proposed to her at the Hoyt Park shelter. Let's see, it was October 75. It was night. We were doing a little cookout, and I put a ring on a taffy apple after dinner. And she started chewing on it and finished it and was about to throw it out without
because
the ring falling down.
Hand.
It got stuck in the taffy, and it didn't come down. I said, do you want to look at that a little closer before you throw it away? And that's how we proposed. And ever since then, on October 4th, every year I've gotten her a taffy apple.
That's right. And they were married October 23rd, 1976.
Right. junior. Karen was a senior. I asked her out on a date because I thought she was a sophomore.
Our first date was to the Bucks Lakers game at the Coliseum.
Our second date, we went to the high school basketball tournament at the Fieldhouse. I am so clever, it's hard to believe.
We saw a lot of basketball.
Thank you.
No.
Oh. Yes. Oh. 52 years?
52 years. 52 years.
So 52 years, four kids, and 14 grandchildren
15.
Later.
One's on the way.
One's on the way. 15 grandchildren later, we're still together.
Yep, here we are.
Hard to believe.
As time goes on, I realize just what you mean to me. And now that you're near.
Yes, our story began in our freshman or sophomore year of high school when I mentioned to my friend Margie Mooney that I thought you were nice. That's the end of chapter one.
It continues about 10 years later when Margie suggested we go skating at Tenney. And so we did. And we communicated for a little while, but then nothing really came of it.
Then in December of 1981, I sent you a Christmas card. I was living in Ohio at the time. And I suggested that maybe we could get together over the holidays when I was home. We did, and we went to a movie. We went cross-country skiing at Black Hawk Ridge. We went skating at Tenney again. And something had really clicked.
So a few months of communicating through real mail and expensive phone calls and a visit to Ohio. In May, I asked you to marry me. And in December of 1982, we were married.
And this past December, we celebrated our 40th wedding anniversary, having raised four children and welcomed their spouses. And right now we have seven grandchildren who we enjoy very much. Who knows what the next chapter is going to be?
Remember when I was young? So you, time stood still, and love was all we knew. You were the first, so was I, who made love and then you cried. Remember when
I first met Jim in the summer of 1969 at a get-together they had for all the incoming freshmen at Edgewood, and I instantly liked him. So when we got to high school, I decided to look him up, and he didn't remember me.
Yeah, I didn't remember Terry at all.
My friends decided to lobby him for the first 3 years of high school to take me to homecoming or prom.
I asked somebody different every single year.
And I was crushed. So finally, the senior year, he invited me to homecoming.
And that is when Terry captured my heart.
We decided once we were juniors in college that we wanted to get married.
I met with Terry's dad to ask for permission, and he was not very keen on the idea. He just thought we were way too young.
Well, we were only 20, and he probably was right. We were too young, but my parents loved him like a son.
No surprise there. And here we are, 42 years later.
Yeah. 47 years later.
Oh, yeah. Well, time flies when you're having a good time. We've got two kids, two boys, two wonderful daughter-in-laws, and four terrific grandchildren.
We truly are blessed, and I'd walk through fire for this man.
I'm so all right with me, 'cause you make me feel so brand new.
first date, December 9th, 1972.
Had a couple basketball tickets that I got to the Wisconsin game and tried calling a few people. They couldn't go. I remember freshman year, Mrs. McGee's class, Bridget sat next to me, and I always wanted to kind of get to know her. Gave her a call. She was available. So we went to the game.
Wasn't too sure. He, a high school jock. I didn't know for sure. I just got done with ACT, my grades. I just thought, oh, okay, what the heck? And it was instant connection.
Yeah, we did. And went to McDonald's that night after the game. And 45 years later,
here we are.
Here we are.
I've been searching a long time. Someone exactly like you. I've been traveling all around the world, waiting for you to come through.
Hi, everybody. It's Mary Jo Quinn.
And J.M. Blank.
And we're supposed to let you know how we met each other. So in 1992, I was at the Laurel with some Edgewood friends.
Over Christmas.
Yeah. And I saw Jay there. He was with some Edgewood people. And I said to him, aren't you Jay Ambling? And he says,
aren't you Mike Quinn's little sister?
I go, yeah, I guess I still am. And he said to me, what are you doing these days? I said, oh, I'm a lawyer in D.C. He goes, well, what kind of lawyer? I go, a finance lawyer. Well, what kind of finance lawyer? I go, a public finance lawyer. And he says, oh, I'm a public finance investment banker. And I said, yeah, right. And if I had been a brain surgeon, what would you have been? So it was kind of an inauspicious beginning. And then we got married at the Edgewater.
Night and day, you are the one. Only you beneath the moon and under the sun. Whether near to me or far, it's no matter, darling, where you are.
Judy and I met each other in high school, but it wasn't until we took a ski trip out west to Salt Lake City where we got to know each other.
Yep, and it was on that bus ride out to Alta, Utah, when people were starting to go to sleep and Joe saw my overhead light on and he came and talked to me and we talked all throughout the night. And then the next morning I misplaced my money and Joe came up to me and offered me his. It was kind of those knight in shining armor moments, but it was that point when he really captured my heart. And so throughout the years we've kind of connected the dots back to that trip. In fact, Joe bought me this pillow once for Christmas, and it says, it all began on a bus. So cute.
We dated that summer after high school for a little bit, on and off. And then Judy was taking off with Marinelle Hansen to go to Europe. We wrote each other a couple times, but it wasn't until she got back from Europe that we met each other again at Westmoreland on the 4th of July.
Joe left for California that fall, and it was when he was gone when he asked me to marry him. And I remember sitting in my parents' basement at 1 in the morning when he proposed. I was all of 19 years old and in college, and I remember it only took me a moment, and I thought about it and said, well, that sounds like fun. You know, let's give it a try. And really, from there, nothing else seemed to matter. We were so young.
So apparently the experiment worked. We have now been married 47 years. We have three fine boys and their wives, seven grandchildren who are the center of our lives.
My old friend, I recall the times we had hanging on my wall. I wouldn't trade them for gold, 'cause they laugh and they cry me, they somehow sanctify me, the woven in the stories I have told. And tell again, my old friend, I apologize
years that have passed since the last time you and I dusted off those memories. But the running and the races, the people and the places, there's always somewhere else I had to be. And time gets thin, my old friend. Don't know why. Don't know why. Don't know why. Don't know why. Whenever I call you friend, I begin to think I understand. Anywhere we are, you and I have always been. Ever and ever, I see myself within your eyes. And that's all I need to show the world. Everything I do always takes me home.
I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky. The first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, or I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. I'm gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open.
We get it almost every night. When that moon gets a big and bright, it's supernatural delight. Every border was dancing in the moonlight. Everybody here is out of sight, but they don't bark and they don't bite. They keep things loose, they keep things alive. Every border was dancing in the moonlight.
Dancing in the moonlight. Everybody's feeling warm and bright. It's such a fine and natural sight. Everybody's dancing in the moonlight.
We like our fun and we never fight. You can't dance and stay uptight. It's supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing.
You got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by.
I'm alright, nobody but about me. Why you got to give me a fight? Can't you just let it be? I'm alright, don't nobody but about me. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me be? Do what you like. I'm alright, nobody but about me. Why you got to give me a fight? Can't you just let me? I'm alright, nobody but about me. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me be?
Who do you want? Who you gonna be tonight?
I'm alright, nobody but about me.
Yeah. You are my love and my life, and you are my inspiration.
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is old and older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like the breeze. Country roads sing, take me home to the place I belong. Mountain mama, take me home, country road. All my memories together around her. Mine is a lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrops in my eyes. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain
this in the morning hour she calls me. The radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Yesterday, country roads take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, I want to hear you now. Country roads take me home. Mama, oh mama, take me home. Country roads, take me home. That country road.
I talked to Terry, and she said yes, and then I called Judy and said, we'll do it, and then I called my sister Kathy and said, please help us. So Kathy was a great help, as you heard, I had lots of ideas of things that I thought we wanted to put into this video. Kathy made it all happen. Terry spent hours searching for songs to add to the video. So frankly, all of you did a great job of sharing photos with us too. The theme of our 50-year reunion video is then and now. And so we collected the now photos from many of you, so I appreciate all of you that shared photos with us. The then photos were pretty much taken from our yearbook and some of the things that Bill Brandt had in his archives way back in the day. In addition to being then and now, we really wanted to focus on the connection that we have with one another. So there's some little vignettes in here about the friendships that we've enjoyed over our lives, lifetime, and some little special vignettes about some of our alumni who have a stronger bond, a little more special connection. So, and we do have audio with this, so I'm hoping the audio will be a little louder than the last one.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted, till your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same thing. But you never forget all the ones who love you and the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything,
messages of thanks for putting this on and how much people wish that they would be here, and they also said they want us to have a good time tonight. A few people that we'd like to acknowledge is Dennis McKinley. He's an EHS ambassador, and he's almost all of our reunions over the years. We want to also thank the previous reunion committees who have helped to keep us connected over the years. Good job, right? We have music tonight provided, after this program, we have music tonight provided by Jerry Joyce and Kevin Dearest, and we thank you for that.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs in still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.